Productions.
10 things to know before you go to Napa. I'm Chris, this is Topher. Together we make Yellow Productions. We do travel guides that are fun, informative, and entertaining. And in this video, we'll be telling you everything you need to know to visit wine capital of the USA, the Napa Valley. Number one, the best time to come. The best time to come to Napa is during harvest season, which is late August, September, October. Most people want to come to Napa in June, July, and August. It's going to be really hot in those times. We're here in August. The high temperatures were in the 90s in the day, pretty toasty. So if you want it to be cooler, come in September or October. In the summer, it's also really busy. Kind of like Christmas time at Costco, you'll be standing in line for just about everything. And the hotel room rates are going to be sky high in the summer. So pick those shoulder seasons right after summer, or you could come in the spring. The mustards are blooming, but the grapevines won't be. So that end of summer, best time to come for the grapes. Also, if you're coming in the summer, there's a morning fog, which can be quite deceptive. It might seem like it's going to be a cool day. It starts cool, but still gets blazingly hot. The second thing to know before you come to Napa is that Napa is expensive. Yes, you heard it right. Everything here is kind of like Disneyland pricing, and you're going to be spending a lot of money. There will be something you'll look at while you're here and be like, oh my gosh, does it really cost that much? The winery we were just at had a flight of caviar for only $110. Pretty reasonable price for caviar. If you are doing wine tastings are going to cost you somewhere in the neighborhood of $20 to $75. Why? Well, because they can and people pay it. The third thing to know before you visit Napa is that Napa is more than just the city or town of Napa. It's really a whole region. People, when they say Napa, they usually think of the Napa Valley, but there's also the Sonoma Valley next door. There's Mendocino. So it's a really big region. To go from Napa up to Calistoga or St. Helena, where a lot of the popular wineries are, it's about an hour drive. So be prepared for a bit of driving when you're in this region, because it's actually a pretty large size. The fourth thing to know about Napa is about how to get here, getting to Napa. It's actually, although it's kind of in the middle of nowhere, it's conveniently located in the middle of nowhere amongst a lot of big cities. It is 40 miles south of Sacramento. It is 50 miles north of San Francisco. It's about an hour drive from each. You can fly into Sacramento Airport, San Francisco Airport, Oakland Airport, or San Jose Airport. So take a look at flights to each of those and figure out where it's cheapest for you. There's rental car facilities to all of them. We flew into San Jose because there were some of the cheapest rates on Southwest. Do check out Southwest to Oakland and San Jose for some pretty cheap fares. So you'll pretty much want a rental car to come from those airports. Your other option, there are buses that you can take from San Francisco or Oakland to come to the Napa region, but then you'll be hard-pressed to get around here without a car. So the fifth thing to know is about public transit. Public transit in the Napa region, pretty much non-existent. So you'll really want a rental car. Your other option is there are these like Napa wine tours or Napa wine excursions, and those will take you out to different wineries. That way you can be drinking and not driving, but drinking and passengering. The sixth thing to know before you go to Napa is about reservations. Make reservations. Make reservations for meals, lunch, dinner. Make reservations for wineries. Yes, wineries require you to make reservations. At least the busy ones do. Some of them only accept reservations if you want to visit. So plan out the wineries you want to go to, make a reservation. Also, dinner, Napa's a pretty popular place to eat. And if you're coming in the summer or busy weekend, make a reservation. Otherwise, you won't get a seat. You'll thank me later. Number seven, wake up early. Napa is a kind of an early place. Things here close really early. The wineries, they close at like 5 or 6 p.m. That's primarily to prevent drunk driving. So get started in the morning. A lot of people, they come in as a day trip from San Francisco, so they aren't here before noon. So if you're here before noon, then you'll be the only one at the winery. After 12, 1, 2 o'clock, that's like the super busiest time at the wineries. They'll be packed. You'll be standing in long lines, and that's when you won't want to be there. The eighth thing to know before you come to Napa is about nightlife, or the lack thereof. There's basically no nightlife in Napa. The only thing you'll be doing here at night is eating at restaurants. If you're gonna do that, then you better do that before 9 p.m. too, because that's probably about the last seating. The ninth thing to know before you come to Napa is about food. We just talked about restaurants. That's the only nightlife that's here. And food in Napa, there's actually really good food in Napa. Napa has some famous restaurants. The most famous restaurant in Napa is French Laundry. I've never been there because I could never get in, make a reservation well ahead of time. Famous worldwide. There's also the Culinary Institute of America in Napa. So I think you'll like the eating here. I will say a couple of places that we dined at. We dined at an Italian place called Bistro Don Giovanni. Pretty good Italian food. Also make a reservation if you want something more on the lower end scale. And by lower end, I don't mean awful, but just less casual. Check out the Oxbow Market. It's a public market built by the same guy who created the market at the ferry terminal in San Francisco. Or for lunch, the problem for lunch though is that like all the food is in the town of Napa, and there's not really much food up near the wineries in like St. Helena and places like that. So think about doing a picnic lunch. The V. Satui Winery has really good picnic fixins. There's also a Dean and DeLuca across the street. You can pick up picnic supplies from there. Those are both in St. Helena, so check those out for a cheap and quick lunch. The final thing you will want to know before you come to Napa is to not drink too much. You know, every winery you go to, you get a tasting, they're in these little 2 ounce glasses. 2 ounce glasses add up by the time you're at your second or third winery that you've got 5 2-ounce glasses, right? They seem like a flight, they seem small, but again, pour it all together and you'll feel like you drank a whole bottle pretty quick. Especially on hot days, the wine will go to your head pretty quick. And if you're coming with a large party, you know, maybe do a designated driver or something like that, or check out those wine excursions I talked about. Then you don't even have to drive. And if you're small, then, you know, moderate, because you'll just want a small amount of wine, like Topher. All right, well, that concludes our video. I hope now you know everything you need to know before you come to Napa. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up below, or consider subscribing to us for more videos every week, or follow us on Google+, Facebook, or Twitter, links in the description below. Or you might enjoy clicking over here to watch another one of our videos on Napa. All right, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.